Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over the XLOOKUP function in a little more detail. This is a new function that is available in Excel 365, but if you have a version prior to that, say you have Excel 2019 or earlier, you will not be able to use this function. So XLOOKUP is a vast improvement over the other lookup functions that you may be used to, such as VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, or the index match. You can look to the left or the right. You can look in columns, or you can look in rows. You can look for an exact match. You can look for data with a wildcard. You can look for the first instance of data or the last. And keep in mind that by default, that is an exact match, and you no longer have to enter that in like you did for VLOOKUP. You can enter in custom data for any text that is not found, and you can return more than one column of data. So let me show you how you can use XLOOKUP. I've created a spreadsheet for a game that we are going to play today. The rules of this game are, I'm going to type in the name of a song, and I'm going to play a snippet of that song for the people that I'm playing this game with. And the object of the game is for the people who are listening to be able to guess the artist of that song as quickly as possible for a point. So I want to be able to type in my song quickly and return the artist information so I can tell who won. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to type in any one of my songs in my list. So for today, I'm going to pick Paradise City. First, I would like to show you that the position of the song and the artist does not matter. On this sheet, I have the song to the left of the artist. I've also created another data sheet where I have the song to the right of the artist. And I'm going to show you that this does not matter when you're using the XLOOKUP function, like it does matter in other functions such as VLOOKUP. So if I go back to sheet one and I click on the artist, I'm going to type in equals XLOOKUP and a left parenthesis. The first question I'm being asked is, what is my lookup value? I want to look up whatever song I have entered in here. The next argument I'm being asked for is the lookup array. Where is the data that will match what I have typed in H2? That data on this sheet will be found in column A. And then I'm going to hit a comma, and then what value am I going to want to return? I'm going to choose the artist column because that's the data that I'm looking for in column B. And then I'm going to hit enter, and I will see that I get the correct result. Now I would like to show you that in reverse. If I go back to my function and I click up here, you can see that I have selected column A first as the column that I'm looking for data in, and then column B, which is the data that I want to return. So let's see that in reverse. Here, I'm going to type XLOOKUP and a left parenthesis. First of all, I'm going to select the value that I am looking up. That is the name of the song right here in H2. The next argument I need to enter is my lookup array. Again, where am I looking for the data? This is a song title, but on my second sheet, I have the songs listed second. So I'm going to highlight this time column B. And then I'm going to put a comma. And then what is my return array? My return array is the name of the artist that I would like to return. I'm going to highlight that column for now, and I'm going to hit enter. And when I go back and look, it's still the same artist. So if you look here, you will notice that column A was selected first and then B, because column A had the song title right here. On my next example, you will see that column B was selected first with a return value of A because I had a sheet where it was in the reverse. The song came second and the artist came first. One thing I would like to point out right here with XLOOKUP and how we've just used this function is if you look in either one of my formulas up here, you will see that I did not have to put an argument for an exact match. This is one reason that XLOOKUP is superior to VLOOKUP. In VLOOKUP, I know in the past I have typed in that function and forgotten to change the last argument to false which means I have to have an exact match and I have not gotten the data set that I need to return. XLOOKUP is an improvement on that because it assumes that you want an exact match by default. What would happen if I entered a song title for which I did not have a match in my database over here where I've typed in all of the names of my songs and the artists and information about that song? One of the most popular songs in the world is Bohemian Rhapsody, and I did not include that song in this list. But what if that was the song that I played a snippet of? What would happen? I would type equals X look up here with a left parenthesis, like I did last time. What's my lookup value? Again, it's the song title. Where's my lookup array? Where am I looking up that song title? Right here in this column. What is my return array? The same column that I have for the artist's name. Now I have an optional argument here. If not found. If not found, what would I like to display? I would type in a double quote and say not found, and my parenthesis, and hit enter. So now, when I type in the name of a song that's not in my list, it will say not found. Let's test this. Let's type stressed out. Who is the artist of that song? 21 Pilots, that is correct. If I typed in Dream On, that would be Aerosmith. But if I typed in Bohemian Rhapsody, it would return a value of not found, which is what I would like to do. Next, what would happen if I misspelled the name of a song? I'm going to do stressy out. I'm also being returned with not found. But what if I didn't want to type the whole name of the song? What if I only wanted to type P-A-R-A for Paradise City? What could I do here? How could I get what is entered here in H2 to be seen as a partial for what I'm looking up over here in this column? So if I go back to where my past XLOOKUP formula is, I'm just going to hit the back arrow once so that I'm now inside the parentheses. And then I'm going to put a comma after the if not found argument, and I will be asked about match mode. By default, XLOOKUP does zero. I have already talked about that. But this wildcard character match down here is very, very helpful. So let's select that one for now. So we will insert a number two argument, and I'm going to hit enter on the keyboard. If you look over here, it's still not found. But the reason it's not found is because in this title, we have not put a wildcard character. A wildcard character is a star on the keyboard. So right now I have P-A-R-A, but there's no way to tell Excel that I would like to pick anything that begins with P-A-R-A. So if I click up here and I add a star, it will watch the artist field change. It now recognizes that I want something that begins with P-A-R-A. I can also use this for something that ends with a word or a part of a word. So this time I'm going to put a star and write the word heart. And I see at least one song that has the word heart in it. And when I hit enter on this, it will return with the artist of Britney Spears looking down here from the bottom of my broken heart. If I want a word that's in the middle, I could put a star and then type my and then put another star. And this will return with the Doors for over here on Light My Fire. In another version of this game, you can assign extra points for also knowing the album or the decade that the song came out. So let me show you an example of how this can be done. XLOOKUP will allow you to return not just one field, but multiple fields. So what if I enter the song Beat It, and I would like to return the artist, the album, and the decade all at the same time? How would I go about doing that? Well, let me show you. I'm going to click under the artist column because that is the first column over here that I would like to return. So under artist, I'm going to type XLOOKUP with a left parenthesis. Again, I'm being asked for my lookup value. It's going to be whatever song I type in this cell, H2. My lookup array, where am I finding the value of that song, again is here. But this time, if I hit a comma, I'm being asked for the return array. Instead of just highlighting column B, I'm going to highlight B, C, and D and drag that all the way to the bottom. And then I'm going to hit enter. Right now I'm being returned with an NA because I have not put the name of a song. But if I go back here and I type in the song, I will get the artist, the album, and the decade, all with one XLOOKUP function. Another option that I can use at XLOOKUP for is to return the last value based on certain criteria. So if I would like to know the last 80s song in my list over here, I could use XLOOKUP to also look that up. So in this case, I would type equals XLOOKUP with a left parenthesis. What is my lookup value? This time, it's going to be what's in cell I2. After I hit a comma, the lookup array, this time I'm going to go with decade, column D. And then finally, the return array that I would like to return, the last name of a song that I have in my list in the 80s. I can do an if not found, again in double quotes, not available. I'm going to type a comma and just let exact match be the default, so I'm not even going to enter anything here. And then finally, I'm going to be asked my search mode. For the search mode argument, I can search first to last, and that will return the first instance of anything in the 80s. But in this case, I'm going to select the negative one argument, which will search from last to first, and it will give me the last option in the list that has the criteria of 80s. Now I'm going to hit enter. And again, Paradise City, let's look over here. Where's my last 80s? It's right here. And looking over here, it is Paradise City. Next, I've created a score tab. If you look down here, I wrote the name score on this tab if you have the spreadsheet to follow along. On this tab, I put the names of the players, and I put what their scores are so far. But in this game, you need 20 points to win. So what I would like to review here is how not only can we have our data now in rows, but we can also have a value that's not an exact match. So here I'm going to type equals XLOOKUP with the left parenthesis. Again, I'm being asked for a lookup value. It's the max score. If I type a comma, I'll be being asked for the lookup array. I'm going to highlight a row this time, row 2. And what return array would I like? I want to return the name of the person that is the predicted winner so far. I'm going to ignore the if not found optional argument by just typing a comma. And now I'm going to come to the match mode. In this case, I want an exact match to this 20 or the next smaller item. You can also do the next larger item, but this time I know that there hasn't been a determined winner yet. We're just looking for the predicted winner. So I'm going to select the next smaller item and then hit enter on the keyboard. The name Jen is returned, but say it's the next round and Steve now has 17 points. If I change that, Steve will now be the next predicted winner. So in summary, XLOOKUP is a very, very robust new function in Excel 365. You can look to the left or the right. You can look in columns or you can look in rows. You can look for an exact match. You can look for data with a wildcard. You can look for the first instance of data or the last. And keep in mind that by default, that is an exact match, and you no longer have to enter that in like you did for VLOOKUP. You can enter in custom data for any text that is not found, and you can return more than one column of data like we did when we returned the artist, the album, and the decade that the music came out. So I hope you learned. a lot more about XLOOKUP through this little tutorial. And if you have any questions, please leave a comment below or visit our website at MyExcelOnline.com. Thanks and look forward to seeing you again.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.